Welcome to the program. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Thank you so much for joining us here on Health Professional Radio. Our guest is a returning guest. He's Dr. Mark Sherwood of the Functional Medical Institute in Tulsa, Oklahoma. When he was here before, we talked about a variety of things that he and his wife, Michelle, do out there in Tulsa at their facility. Today, we're going to talk about two other aspects of their practice, nutrigenomics and nutrigenetics. Welcome back to the program, Dr. Mark Sherwood. It's been a long time.
Thank you, Neil, for having me. I really appreciate it very much.
Thanks for coming back. For those who aren't familiar with you from the last time that you were here, the Functional Medical Institute in Tulsa, when did you start that practice?
We started the practice approximately 6.5 years ago, and since then it has grown drastically. We have patients in 27, 28 states and 4 or 5 countries now, I believe. Our philosophy is based upon complete wellness, optimizing all parts of our health. So we really have 4 parts of our program that we work on and instill this in the patient's life. One is lifestyle, and all aspects of lifestyle do apply there. We want that to be right. We talk about genetics. Genetics are our map, if you will, and how to map lifestyle. We talk about measurables. Measurables are going to be like blood work, body composition, certain urine markers per se. Those have to be right, because if they are wrong, obviously we're expressing genetics wrong. And then over the top of what we do, we have certain principles, and we call them sound principles, that we operate by. If it doesn't fit in that sound principle box, we don't do it. And we think principles such as don't spend more than you make, you know, little things like that really matter.
Now, just to clarify, you and your wife, you are not geneticists, are you?
No, sir, we're not. We are a wellness-based integrative medical practice. We focus on all parts of the person. We have 2 purposes. Number one is to eliminate all self-imposed, choice-driven diseases from the planet. And number two, eliminate all unnecessary usage of medication. And by achieving both of those goals, we believe that we can create people who are walking at optimum health.
And keep in mind, you know, listeners, he did say unnecessary use of pharmaceuticals, because there are times when those are going to work best in certain situations, right?
That is very correct. And I'll give an example that I've given many times to patients. If I were to have some sort of an accident where I broke a bone, you know, I don't want fish oil and curcumin to try to kill the pain. I want something a little more heavier than that. And those uses of medications are extremely important. I am so grateful we have good scientists and pharmacists who develop those things. So we do need them from time to time. However, on the other side of the coin is the overdependence upon the usage to manage conditions that can be eradicated very simply with lifestyle change.
You know, a big part of everyone's lifestyle is how and what and when we eat. Let's talk about how our food affects our genes.
Yeah, interestingly enough, we all have genes, but Neil, all of us as individuals are 99.9% identical, which is fascinating. When we talk about the 0.1% being different, you can look at the person next to you and we can see a difference, but that 0.1% is so slight, but it's so massive in the same token, because with our genes that are given to us that cannot change, when they are put into an environmental situation, they respond. Well, our environment is consistent with what we do with our body, what we put in the body, and what inputs we give the body through stressors. So those environmental inputs, specifically to your question regarding nutrition, they cause the genes to respond, and they actually react. That is called nutrigenetics. When you talk about changing the way the genes express themselves, in other words, we can nutritionally do things to the genes to cause them to express themselves in a different way. That is nutrigenomics. So nutrigenetics is the genes' interaction with the environment. Nutrigenomics are the environment's effect upon the genes.
What is the optimal age where you can glean the best information about how diet is affecting genes and how those changes will affect the person later in life?
The two schools of thought on that, and I'll give you both. Number one, adults can handle adult information. So we know that adults need this. Everyone needs this to actually do it and let us help you establish the optimum lifestyle plan to maximize your genetic potential. We are not opposed to doing people who are under adult age, let's say 10, 11, 12, 13. But here's where the sticking point becomes, is because we talk about in this our genetic potential, even athletic potential, what we don't want to have is perhaps parents trying to control too much of the childhood with too much information. So it's almost like information in the wrong hands can become a disaster. So we are very cognizant about that. We're very picky about what people we use that are underage allow to go through the process.
What about the use of supplements in order to, I guess, help some of this genetic expression along? Is that something that is ever considered?
Oh, very much so. Because one thing that we're able to glean from the genes is how much, for example, if we have inflammatory sequences of SNPs that are overexpressive within the context of our environment, we have to come at that a little bit harder as opposed to someone who is less expressive. And many times what we do to reduce the overexpression of pro-inflammatory genetic markers is we add high dosages of omega-3 fatty acids, and that may be up to 3, 4, 5 grams per day, and along with perhaps 3 or 4 or 5 grams of high-dose curcumin. Now, you compare that with a person who does not have ultra-high inflammatory marker expression, and you put that much fatty acids on a person, that could actually abnormally drive their lipids or their blood fats in the wrong direction. So when you're talking about standardization of supplementation, we see it all the time, and it really does free up people from the pathway, if you will, of wondering what to take and falling into the trap of, well, I need to take this for fear that I don't have enough. And we see people that are over-supplemented many, many times because, as stated, if we take too many antioxidants from the outside, that slows the body's own internal antioxidant capacitor to quench free radicals. Case in point on that, when you take in an antioxidant from the outside or exogenously, it quenches free radicals on a one-to-one basis. So for one antioxidant, one free radical. But when you're able to turn on the internal antioxidant capacity through an enzyme, which is called superoxide dismutase, mm-hmm. for example, that one, if turned on properly, is able to quench million free radicals in 1 second. So which one's more effective, internal or external? In this case, internal. So taking too many antioxidants in some people, like multiple doses of high-dose vitamin C, et cetera, or high-dose IV therapies, can sometimes, in some people, genetically be too much, thereby suppressing their own internal system, which is more effective, and that's actually the normal design for us.
Where can we go online and get some more information about you, your practice there at the Functional Medical Institute in Tulsa?
Yeah, go to www.fmi, as in Functional Medical Institute, so fmidr.com, and we have a video for every one of our services, and love to have people just check it out, and if nothing else, learn a lot about what is possible in our lives.
Dr. Mark Sherwood, always a pleasure. Thank you so much for coming back.
Thank you, Neil. I appreciate you.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Transcripts and audio of the program are available at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can subscribe to this podcast on iTunes, listen in, and download at SoundCloud, and be sure and visit our affiliates page at hpr.fm.